for Cairo and then for my own country, I want to express on behalf of Rosalind, my wife, myself, and all the American party, our gratitude to the government and to the people of Israel for your hospitality and for your kindness. I came here in the service of a cause which binds together, which unites Israel, Egypt, and the United States of America, the sacred cause of peace. We have taught and reasoned together in that cause for many hours during the past 3 days. We've talked as friends, and our conversations have been characterized by the frankness and concern that true friendship demands. In our discussions, we've concentrated on the differences that still exist between Egypt and Israel in the peace process. Differences that are now very small compared to the most of agreement. Good progress has been made. There are fewer differences than when I first arrived, and those few differences which still remain have been substantially narrowed. Last night, there were further intensive discussions among members of the Israeli cabinet and the United States delegation on the two or three most difficult issues. Building on those discussions, Prime Minister Begin and I were able to make substantial additional progress. I will now fly to Cairo to review with President Sadat the discussions that we have had here and the progress which we have made together. As I depart, I want to repeat once again what I said in the Knesset yesterday. The friendship between America and Israel is more than strong. It is indestructible. In the past 3 days, I have been impressed deeply by the extraordinary story of faith and perseverance in the face of adversity, which is Israel. President Sadat, Prime Minister Begin, and I remain determined to exert every ounce of effort at our command to bring the peace negotiations to a successful conclusion. We will not fail. Thank you very much.
אדוני נשיא ארצות הברית, אדוני נשיאה של מדינת ישראל, גבירותיי ורבותיי, בבואו של הנשיא, אורחנו הדגול, אמר לו נשיאנו שלנו, ברוך תהיה בבואך. היום אני אומר לנשיא ארצות הברית, ברוך תהיה בצאתך. באת אלינו ועשית עבודה למען קידום השלום. הצלחת, אדוני הנשיא. אנחנו התקדמנו בתהליך השלום. נכון, נותרו בעיות שעדיין לא נפתרו, ועכשיו כמובן תורה של מצרים לתת את תשובתה. אנחנו עשינו כל מאמץ אפשרי כדי לעזור לך בשליחות השלום שלך. אנחנו מודים לך ולרעייתך על אשר כיבדתם אותנו בביקור הזה, שיהיה בוודאי בלתי נשכח לך, לנו ולשני ימינו, ובצאתך למצרים להמשך שליחות השלום אנו מאחלים לך מקרב לבנו הצלחה מלאה. Mr. President of the United States, Mr. President of the State of Israel, ladies and gentlemen. We take leave of you, Mr. President, on behalf of the government and the people of Israel. On behalf of them, I wish to express our gratitude, my wife and myself, and all my colleagues in the cabinet, that you honored us with your visit, you and your gracious lady, the Secretary of State and Secretary of Defense, and your other advisors. Undoubtedly, those 3 days of your visit to Israel were three hectic days. And there were also three white nights. But they are memorable days. I believe they will be unforgettable. Mr. President, you came on the highest mission in humanity for peace. And you have succeeded. We made real progress in the peacemaking process. Now, of course, it's the turn of Egypt to give its reply. Nobody can deny that we worked as expeditiously as humanly possible. And therefore, we worked day and night. And we are not tired because of the elation in our hearts that we did a good job in the service of peace. Mr. President, may I say respectfully that you can leave this country with satisfaction. And we are happy that we could have helped you to the best of our ability. And when you embark on your journey and mission to Egypt, we wish you Godspeed. And when you come back home, may I again ask you, tell the great American people that here is a free nation which loves and respects your great country, your people, and is grateful for their friendship and cherishes your personal friendship for Israel, which is a treasure in our time. So, Mr. President, now we shall wish you all the success in Egypt, and we shall guard our friendship between America and Israel forever.
Thank you very much. Beautiful pleasure.
Thank you.
I have a statement to make, which I consider to be extremely important. I have just given to President Sadat a full report on my discussions in Israel. During that visit, the United States made proposals for resolving a number of outstanding issues, proposals which were accepted by Prime Minister Begin and his cabinet. President Sadat has now accepted these proposals. Based on discussions in Egypt and Israel, I have also presented United States proposals to President Sadat and to Prime Minister Begin for resolving the few remaining issues. Earlier today, Prime Minister Begin agreed to present these proposals to his cabinet for consideration. This will be done at the earliest opportunity. President Sadat has carefully reviewed all these remaining issues and has accepted these same proposals. I have just informed Prime Minister Begin by telephone of President Sadat's acceptance. I am convinced that now we have defined all of the main ingredients of a peace treaty between Egypt and Israel, which will be the cornerstone of a comprehensive peace settlement for the Middle East. Thank you.
Mr. President, 6 days ago, you left for the Middle East in search of peace. You and Rosalind took with you our love, our prayers, and the hopes of all humanity. You return tonight to a happy and a grateful nation, for you have drawn two ancient enemies to the brink of peace. We thank you tonight not only for the breakthrough in the Middle East, but we thank you also for renewing our confidence in the deepest of American values. Where there were risks, you stood for hope. And where there were obstacles, you followed conscience. Where there were suspicions, you sought to build a lasting foundation of trust. It is the trust that you won from President Sadat and Prime Minister Begin that made these historic discussions possible, and it is that same trust that made these talks a success. Mr. President, Rosalind, welcome home to a proud and a hopeful nation.
Thank you. I'd like to ask Secretary Vance to come up here and stand. Vice President Mondale, Speaker O'Neill, Senator Byrd, members of the Congress, a tremendous group of the members of the Congress, members of my cabinet, friends and fellow citizens. You're looking at a tired but a grateful man. All of us who made this journey appreciate the opportunity that we have had to render some service in the cause of peace. Now the journey is done, and we're glad to be home, back in our own country, our beloved United States of America. It's good to see so many familiar and welcome faces, and I want to thank you for being out here in the middle of the night to greet us and to give us one of the best welcomes I have ever known. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. As you know, we did not go to Egypt and to Israel in order to confirm what was already a guaranteed result. We went there to use our influence and our good offices to help the leaders of those two great nations move decisively toward that peace that is so ardently desired by the people whom they serve. There were risks involved. They were pointed out to me by many people. Political risks to me as president. Therefore, perhaps a risk even to the prestige of the United States. Fortunately, our work has had a happy result. But I want to stress that the effort would have been worth making, regardless of the outcome of this trip. Risk of failure should never deter us from a worthy goal, and no goal is higher than that of genuine peace. In war, we offer our very lives as a matter of routine, and we must be no less daring, no less steadfast in the pursuit of peace.
For more than 30 years, the nations of Egypt and Israel, who have been and who will be perpetual neighbors, have existed in a continual state of hostility. That hostility has exploded into combat four times, and each war has brought with it suffering and pain and the loss of life, renewed fear and hatred, and great danger for that entire region and for the world far beyond. But in the last 16 months, the way has finally been opened to peace. When I decided to make this trip, the peace negotiations, as you know, seemed to have reached a stalemate. After long hours of discussion in both Egypt and in Israel, proposals were made for resolving all the outstanding issues. All but two of these issues have been resolved with Prime Minister Begin and the Israeli cabinet. In less than 3 hours from now, the Prime Minister will present the remaining proposals to the Israeli cabinet for consideration. I have even left instructions to wake me up if the news is good. And I believe it will be. As you also know, President Sadat has already accepted all of the proposals. Therefore, we have now defined the major components of a peace treaty between the largest and most powerful Arab country, Egypt, and her neighbor and former enemy, Israel. There may be sharp internal debates before this process is complete, but the treaty that emerges can be the cornerstone of a comprehensive settlement, one that can bless with peace all the people who have suffered from the long enduring conflict in the Middle East. The leaders of Egypt and Israel are now daring to break the pattern of bitterness and war. They are following the advice of the biblical proverb, when a man's way please the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him. In choosing peace, President Sadat and the Prime Minister of Israel, Prime Minister Begin, are venturing into the unknown. But they know that the United States of America will be with them as they begin to make peace a living reality for their own people. I'm thankful that the friendships between their countries, both countries, and the United States will now grow even stronger when our own two friends are friends with one another. Through private messages and public statements, many messages sent from Air Force One on the trip back here from Egypt, I am urging all other world leaders to support what Egypt and Israel have done, for it offers hope to all who love peace everywhere in the world. My friends, let me thank you again for coming out to greet us. I believe that God has answered our prayers.
I'm afraid of some of the same problems. Thank you.